Hi everyone. Today we're going to talk about writing an effective introduction for use in written work or in presentations. One of my students came up with a great name for this framework, which is called the Martini Glass. What that's going to allow us to do is to go from big ideas to specifics. We're going to be able to provide the audience with the background they need so that they understand what we're talking about. And we're going to use context to show how important or new our work is. So the reason we call this the Martini Glass Framework is because of the shape of a martini glass. What we're aiming to do is provide as much wide information as we can up front and then get narrower and narrower until we get to the point of our work in particular. The idea being that if we went straight to the point, no one would understand what we're talking about or why. To apply our martini glass approach, I've picked out an example, just a random paper from the Journal of Membrane Science. This is the title of the paper. It's written out. There's some words in it I probably can't produce. But if you're interested in finding this paper for yourself, you can just search the title with Google and it should come up. And you should be able to access it through your university library. What I'm really interested in looking at in this paper to see how the martini glass approach works is the introduction that these authors have written. And what we're going to do is look at their introduction section and see if we can break it down into the ideas they have in each paragraph of that introduction and see how those relate to the martini glass concept. To sum up the content of their first paragraph, they talk about how heavy metals are a toxin in the environment and why that's important. So it's a very big picture idea. In this opening paragraph, they don't provide a lot of detail. What they're conveying is that heavy metals in the environment are bad and it would be great if we could remove them. That links nicely into their next paragraph, which is about the different kinds of techniques that are used to remove heavy metals in the environment. And again, there's not a lot of detail on these techniques, but they provide the names of them and show what techniques are available. They end their paragraph on removing heavy metals by mentioning a technique called absorptive membranes. And then that links nicely into their next paragraph, which is about absorptive membranes. So now we're starting to focus on a relatively narrow part of the field. We've gone from heavy metals in the environment down to all the techniques possible, down to the specific technique these authors are investigating. In their next paragraph, they get even more detailed. They talk about a specific type of membrane, these mixed matrix membranes. Next up, they talk about a specific adsorbent material that they can put in these membranes, this PEI, and they add quite a lot of detail about why PEI is good for this application and some of the numbers and quantitative analysis on PEI. And then for their last paragraph, they talk about specifically what they've done in terms of their study on these materials. So what these authors have done is they've started out very nicely by telling us about the broad field, and then they've got a little bit more specific, started talking about the specific techniques, and then one of those techniques, and then the type of chemistries that are required to make that technique work, and then the specific, very specific thing that they've done in the study. So they've gone from this broad picture, broad wide view up here, all the way down to their specifics, and they've added more and more detail as they've gone down. So with this martini glass approach, you can prepare any kind of introduction, starting from your broad topic and going all the way down to the specific thing that you're investigating or working on.